Well, hello there, everybody. Dre here, and welcome back to the game where we are quickly running out of space to build. We're playing some more Marble World today, and man, has Scrap Man been busy. So he built the latest obstacle in this collaborative effort to build the world's longest marble run course, and he built not one, but two cannons? Usually I'm the large builder in this series. He went next level and essentially built an obstacle that goes all the way across the room. The funny thing is, my next plan was to build a cannon, so it looks like Scrapman beat me to the punch. But that's okay. I think he did a better job. It looks absolutely fantastic, and I'm excited to see how it actually works. But yeah, if you're just stumbling upon this series, don't really know what's going on, this is a series where me and Scrapman are working together to build a massive obstacle course. Each episode, we go back and forth designing the end of the course. In the last episode that I did, I built this skee ball course, which goes into a reward section. The better your points in the skee ball, the higher you go up this ladder. And Scrapman has built from here these two massive cannons. I'm interested to see how this works because this cannon has these massive banks with obviously an option to come down here. Well, it's not an option. You don't want to go down there, but it looks like that's the penalty if you somehow fall off this. I'm curious to see how it works going into a massive cannon here, into whatever this green thing is, and all the marbles are ending off over here. But yeah, as we always do at the start, let's get a marble run going just to experience the course and make sure everything's working as intended. All right, 1080 seems good, and we'll see how many can make it to the end. But yeah, this is... Honestly, I did not expect this to go this far, but it's looking so good, and I don't know when we're gonna stop. It's probably gonna have to be soon until we can get bigger maps because, yeah, I don't know what we're gonna do after this. God damn it, I'm still getting leaks. Where is this leaking from? As I always do, I will be, you know, working on the course as we go. Whoa, that was a double jump there. Did you see that? Hopefully I can deal with the majority of the leaks. It has been improving every episode, and, it looks like, yeah, I got a big issue going on here, don't I? It's probably these. I usually don't go this many marbles, and they might be overflowing, so I might need to close these in, just to play it safe, but I'll analyze and go from there later on. I want to see this course in action right now. All right, I'm not going to show you the whole course because, well, we see these every episode now. So if you do want to see all these builds, you'll just have to watch the whole series. But it's looking good so far. It's looking like purple's going to beat this. Nobody has went to the top yet. We have a cheater pumpkin eater. Oh, that's bad. Okay, so I'm having some bouncing to the side. I might need to put a massive board here. If we get any leakages, they could skip ahead. So yeah, I'll probably add some more boards just to make sure this doesn't be affected. But I'm more curious to see how this thing works. Let's see those things get launched. Right into the tube. He put those walls there for that reason. They bounce around a little bit. What I want to see is how do they fall down? Oh, so basically if they hit these side boards, they go backwards because there's no boost here, and that's how they fall off. This is actually a really cool obstacle because you got to perfectly jump all these to get into the cannon, and then obviously, if you don't make it there, you're going to have a long way up, and those balls are going to get way ahead of you. Well, guys, I did it again. I accidentally spent 2 hours just doing some fine-tuning tweaks to the course. And I haven't even started building yet. I have a serious addiction with fixing all the little issues I did when I didn't really care if they all made it to the end or not. But yeah, the course is way better now. I'm not gonna bore you with everything I did. I'll just quickly mention them. I added the walls here. That way, we don't have any cheating and going to the next part of the track. I extended the size of these tubes because they would come out here and sometimes overshoot. I fully enclosed this pathway off as some would shoot fall out from here and shoot out the sides. Added a bank here. Some would go a little too fast and fall over this. Added an extra layer here. When they hit these holes, sometimes they would bounce over the sides. I've extended the size of this wall. Sometimes they would take the jump pad a little too high. The biggest issue has always been these. I'm still working on it, but it's getting better and better. The balls collect in the middle of these, and sometimes just due to the amount of balls in there, they'll go right through the wood. So I've just been moving these around a little bit, and it's been getting better and better. We definitely don't have as many leakages as we once did. Oh, I also added an extra layer up here, just because some were going over the top. And aside from some small tweaks, that's pretty much it. I gotta say it's much more optimized now, but now I gotta actually start building something here. starting from this. All right, so we're taking an idea straight out of Scrapman's design. We're going to make essentially a bigger version of this. So I think if we control V that and then put it like that, is that how he did it? And he just slowly angled these in. It doesn't look like it's on a big enough angle. I might need to angle these more. Okay, I'm pretty sure that's how you do it. We definitely have a little bit of a concave here. Thing is, it's not angled enough. So I'm going to go back and start from scratch. And I'm also going to want it to actually be bigger. So instead of doing 4 of these, we're going to be doing 16. And I think that should be big enough. All right, let's just test this out. Make sure they're all... Okay, I might need to add an extra layer here. These things are going to bounce like crazy. God, I'm going to have to make this huge. The important part is it's working. And as long as they don't go to the edges here, it doesn't look like they're getting stuck anywhere here. So yes, I could make this bigger, but I got to worry about scrap as well. So what I might do instead is maybe put some walls around the side. I don't know. We'll see kind of where this goes. I might use this one or have to make a bigger one. Now in the middle of the design, we're going to have this. We want that obviously a little high so the marbles can get in the middle here. I've already tested it. It doesn't lift it yet, so I gotta figure out a way to get the marbles up to this point. I could use the smaller physics tube. Actually, I can because I wouldn't be able to get in the middle of it, so I'm wondering maybe a bounce pad will make sense. And yeah, that's not gonna work as you can see because it's not actually bouncing. It's just rolling on top of it. Well, that was easy. I just put one of the small boosts in the middle. We're gonna have to work on that trajectory. That is, oh my god, I'm so excited. I don't know if you can tell what I have planned yet. I didn't want to spoil it, but this is exactly what I wanted. Maybe not as high as this, but this gets me, oh my god, I'm so excited right now. And it's all staying within the course. More or less. I might have to actually add a wall to the outside, but that's fine. But yeah, this is fantastic. This is exactly what I wanted. So let's continue building this. Well, I didn't think this through. I'm gonna have to go back to the drawing board. I should just mention what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to design some sort of volcano obstacle. I thought I could just do the same angle strategy that we did with this concave design here, but my brain totally forgot about the fact that these wedges are going to be going out because it's a convex design. So it's not going to look like a volcano at all, and that is not the goal. So I'm gonna have to go back to the drawing board. There's things I could do. I could really use these thin ones and just kind of wrap them around. I might have to go that route. Because, yeah, I don't really have many other options of things I can use that look like a volcano, so... Yeah, I think I'm gonna go for the long stick route, I guess. All right, well, regardless, this should still work out. It's just going to be a lot of things I have to spawn in. And I don't know how much my PC is going to handle. We've added a lot to this course, so I'm a little nervous. But yeah, if we do something like that, it might not be perfectly straight. But I mean, it's a volcano. It's not supposed to be perfect. I actually want them to bounce around in the volcano for a while. So the fact that we have some lips here and whatnot that they can bang into is a really good thing. All right, this is getting dangerous. I just highlighted this and I was below target FPS. So I don't think I'm going to go crazy here. What I have to do, I have this at the lowest possible rotation step. And as you can see, there's still holes. So I went to freehand and oh God, I didn't even copy and paste it yet. This could crash. Oh, I'm so nervous. All right, we're going to save world. And hopefully give it an hour. Oh yeah, that's looking good. Now we control V again. Okay, and is that it? Did I do it? I mean, it's got little holes on the bottom here. I've already, actually, if I control Z, I can grab it again. Oh, let's go. Let's do it one more time. So we're gonna just rotate this once more. Then it should be perfect. And you know what? I mean, considering the options that I had, that kind of looks like a volcano. Okay, I got an idea. I didn't want to add a wall because then it would really ruin the look of the volcano. So what I'm gonna do is continue using this rotation method to put essentially a boost pad hopefully all the way around the outside. Bad news, it does work for the most part now, but not as I hoped. It's so powerful, the sides that is, that it shoots up the mountain. That's kind of not how a volcano works, and that's not what I wanted. So I think I'm going to have to go back to the drawing board and maybe make my bottom platform bigger. I think that's my best option. I could do other things like raise the volcano up a little bit more so it's not shooting up. But even still, like, we're having issues where this is still a little too far out and things are getting stuck, as you can see. So yeah, as much as I hate to say it, I'm going to have to delete, I think, the whole bottom. In case you are wondering how stupidly big this is at this point, this is 1/3 of the blocks that I need. I'm gonna paste them now. It is gotta be at least 1,000 pieces of wood. Probably more. This is gonna break the game. This volcano is gonna be the end of this. All right, unfortunately, even with the bigger one, they're still bouncing back a bit. I want this to be not in the middle because we got to put the volcano in the middle. And if this falls and hits the volcano, it's just going to launch to the left, which is not the goal. The important part is it's working. I might need to add a small wall here or something to bank them this way. Okay, I had to go back to the drawing board for what I don't know, the fifth time now, I think. The issue was I had so many of these damn planks that it was lagging out the game before I even spawned in the marbles. So yeah, that wasn't really gonna work out. I think I'm liking this. I don't want a huge drop. I have to watch out because, yes, I'm hitting other obstacles now. It's just there's no room anymore. Okay, that should be good. I don't think I'm hitting anything. And I don't want an insane drop because I have a lot to design here. And just dealing with these things bouncing off the course is a nightmare to say the least. But this is good. I'm liking this. Let's just make sure we'll do one more test run. Now, there will never be this many spawning in here. So even if they do bang and bounce off a little bit, looks like some are falling over the side. I guess it's just because there's an overflow there, but that's looking real good. None fell off. I'm going to accept that that's as good as we're going to get it. And finally, we can actually work on the volcano. Where did I put that? Okay, it's out here. I have to move things around now because I have to highlight them. And if there's anything behind them when you highlight the whole course and then you ruin everything. Okay, well, that's a volcano if I've ever seen one. A little aggressive. I've put most of these down to like almost nothing too. It's looking good. The lower down it is, the more powerful they are, but I think we gotta drop this seriously down. Thing is, if I drop them too much, they don't get to the next one. So we need like this perfect popcorn effect where they go all the way up this tube. This is gonna be a lot of trial and error. All right, you know what? I think that's as good as we're gonna get it. They're not going crazy, and it does feel like a volcano. It has, like, spurts. Thing is, because of the incline and the speed of this volcano, they are going to shoot off the edge. So, I think I have an idea of what I want to do anyways, and I think it's going to look cool without it looking like a wall. All right, man, I hope this works, because this took a while. That's going to be too big. That should actually fit in there quite well. This was my logic for adding a wall without it looking like a wall. And I'm actually pretty glad that I went this route because it adds more to the scene. It looks like it's this unlucky civilization that lives around this massive volcano. We have this little opening here. There's got to be something I can throw in there. I have boulders and whatnot. You know what? No, let's add a little shrub. There we go. The shrub that blocked everything else. Okay, I have no idea if this will work or not, but yeah, I manually placed all these just to make it look a little more realistic and not so uniform like everything else I've designed here. And let's see what happens when I spawn these in. It should block everything. I'm thinking this should be good. We might have to play with the trajectory a little bit. I just want to make sure nothing is being blocked by any of the housing. There's none going into the patios or anything like that. Oh my god, this is fantastic. This is exactly what I wanted. And honestly, I think that's a good trajectory. We don't want to go too high, because then we're going to lose some of these balls. But yeah, this was the goal. Oh, see, this is what I was talking about. This is what I was worrying about. The shrub is always the answer. Nobody's gonna notice shrubs at the front door anyways. They kind of look like... Oh my god, did you see that? It just climbed over the... What the hell? Two climbed over the shrub? We're gonna have to have shrubs on shrubs. All right, I ended up going for the nails just because it kind of looks like the post, as you can see, and you really can't notice really far away. The shrubs were a little too much. And yeah, it's looking like those nails are doing a good job. I might need to board them up more. Sometimes they get some serious speed behind them. Ah, there we go. See, this is the things I need to work on. When in doubt, shrub it out, guys. We'll just throw a shrub here, and that should be fixed. And yeah, we'll just keep looking for any sort of pockets that these things can possibly get stuck in. I think I got rid of all the issues that could possibly arise, and obviously now we gotta figure out what we want to do next, because, well, we don't want them to just live here. We have to continue on. Scrap still has to build more. I don't know where he's gonna build anything, to be honest, but I'm sure he'll figure it out. So what I think I'm gonna do is kind of have some sort of landing pad at the top, where obviously the goal is to get to that landing pad, but I want them to last in here for a while. I want it to be hard to escape. Maybe even I could maybe open up one of these and have an escape route that way. That might be an option as well. All right, I think if we do something like this, I don't want to go too complex with this design, because I want to give Scrap maybe the option to do something in the sky here, because I know he's going to start running out of options. But if I just have something like this up here, that should get rid of them at a decent speed, as you can see. I don't want them going away too quickly. I want this to be kind of like a trap for, you know, a long time. So yeah, I really like this, because I think if we add some sort of pathway down here, it would take forever for them to get down there, at least with this. When we're not getting into blockages issues, I might have to work on that a little bit. But when we're not getting blocked up like that, we should be good. So that just means I need to boost these a little bit more, which I can do now because I technically have a wall. So this can go a little bit higher. So 5 seem to be the sweet spot. Okay, so yes, put your guesses in the comments below. Who is going to be victorious this time? I know I've said watermelon every time, but for the sake of the volcano, I have to go for my homeboy Lava this time, and we're going to spawn in. I feel like 1,000's a good amount. I don't want to go too crazy, because the course starts getting wonky when you try and put a lot through it. And yeah, both me and Scrap have kind of designed this with about 1,000 in mind, it feels like, at least. All right, but here we go, downwards. God, it's going to be hard to even deal with the camera now, because there's so many things in the way. But it's absolutely fantastic. What do we have first? Neon coming out first. The big question is anybody going to hit the jump pad and get a head start? Oh, green almost getting it. That was exciting. Actually, did gold get it? I totally missed that if gold got it. Somehow gold's ahead now. What happened to gold? It's down now. So sometimes they battle in here. And it looks like maybe Neon got ahead. Maybe gold fell off. I'm not sure. But Neon is now ahead, going into Scrap's course. If it can get in the middle, I think the middle's faster, isn't it? Actually, I don't know. It's hard to tell with this. Awesome design. I have no idea which way you want to go with this one, though. And there we go into the swirly. Neon's way ahead right now, actually. There's nothing even close. So as long as I can keep lucky here. Oh, it went down to the bottom. These ones have a chance to get up now. Oh, almost into the top 50. We have a 50. I think that was yellow. Oh, yellow is so far ahead now. Getting into that 50 that early. 50 is extremely rare, so watermelon way behind yellow. Can it catch up? I don't know. It has to get lucky with the volcano and also this. There are so many things that can screw up now. It's fantastic. Yellow is looking like it's going to make it to the cannon, though. Into the green. Whoa. Okay, I can't. Is it in there? I saw it. Yeah, it's going to wrap back and forth until balls start banging into it. So I don't know if it will win. Blue's coming in. We have the few that are way far ahead right now. This is great that this kind of takes time. Now that we got a bunch in there, oh, it's going to be close. I don't know who's going to win. There's actually quite a few here now. Green almost getting it. Nothing's actually getting it. Come on. White? Of all things, white? Who's going to... No, nobody's going to guess white. That's the most boring of options here. It's looking like we're having a little bit of a buildup up top. It's going to be a lot of tweaking when it comes to this. So it's still working. We just got to get them out of the way. There we go. That seemed to help out a lot, boosting that to a 7. It's looking like a lot are making it, though. That was actually closer than I expected. We had a few getting to here early. The thing is, you actually do need the balls to hit each other at the bottom for this thing to work. So just because you're here early doesn't really mean you're going to win. All right, but on that, guys, I need a break. This was by far the hardest one yet. What the hell did you do that? Oh, you bastards. We're still going to have to work on this a little bit, as you can see. They're still breaking through these damn things. But honestly, I'm just so happy with this design. This has definitely been my favorite build yet, and I hope you guys enjoyed experiencing it with me. As always, guys, thanks for watching and liking, and I'll see you in the next one.